With all things defined, we are ready to optimize. It prompts you in the command line to select EG surface. This will be the mass grading surface for us. So that we can visually see things better, you can change the color of any and all of the defined grading objects if you like. We need to go through the same process we did when creating the mass grading and make sure that under zones, the grading limit we want to use is at the bottom of the tree. We are still able to see the zones we used for mass grading, but we can set them to be not active and turn the visibility off if we want. I can continue to change colors of the grading objects so I can visually see things easier. And I can move any of the zones into the order that I would like for them to be used. Remember that this works like you are layering the zones on top of each other. As you can see, you have access to any and all of the defined objects in the tree. Also, you can make changes here, and those changes will take effect immediately. Under Model Settings, you want to change the mesh quality to low. This will help with performance. Before we select Optimize, we can open the global settings and change the objective weights to focus more on balancing the site or not balancing the site, adjust how it smooths the surface, etc. One thing we will change is the iterations. We will change that number from 100,000 to 50,000 so that when we look at the convergence plot, the graph will be easier to read. We are ready to optimize. If we want to see how the optimization is going, obviously we can just take a look at the surface. But we can also look at the convergence plot and make sure that in the proximity measure graph, the blue line is continuing to make its way down to the bottom of the graph. Depending on how much is going on with the grading, this might move faster or slower. A lot is to be considered around this. Things like size of the property, amount of triangles in the EG surface, and complexity of the grading you're trying to achieve. You can toggle on the visualization toolbar and change to different visual themes. This is also where you can turn on the direction vectors, and arrows will show the intent of the grading. This is a great way to check and see if the contours are shaping up the way that they should. You can also change the interval of the contours on the fly. This also helps you see visually if the grading is forming correctly. We can see visually that the grading that has been generated looks like we want. I can take a look at the convergence plots one last time, and as you can see, the solver has progressed nicely. I've been keeping an eye on the cut fill numbers as they move up and down with the grading, and I can see the contours reflect my design intent. So we will stop the optimization and send the results back to Civil 3D. In the Save Optimization Result dialog, you have three options. We can save the surface, which is what we want to do. We can bring in the feature lines generated in grading optimization so that if we want to further manipulate the grading plan, we can. And we have an option to bring in points. We want to save a new surface. You also have the option to merge the output with an existing surface if needed. We will not be bringing in the feature lines, so we will toggle that option off, and we also will not be bringing in any of the points. I am going to name our new surface Design No Pond. We will get to the pond grading shortly. I also have the option to select the style I would like to use.